So Liverpool in that all dark strip attack the goal to our right, unbeaten in their last 11 games, 9 of which they've won. They've reached the League Cup final. They've conceded only 4 goals in their last 11 matches and scored 30 times. And that's what you call awesome form. Chelsea distinguishable this afternoon. They're the team with the white stockings on. Sammy Lee. Hutchins. Ball back with Nutton, and now with Locke. Chelsea, for their part, have lost only one of their last 14, and that was at Watford last Saturday. Chelsea's throw. Gary Locke, who's had a pretty severe haircut there. Leash playing it back and going straight to Walker with it. Cowley. It's not arrived a little start here for Chelsea towards Rhodes Brown with Neil closing on him. Rhodes Brown getting a touch. Lee getting in quickly. Still Rhodes Brown. And then Hutchins. The occasion getting a little the better of him, particularly as Walker was nicely placed just inside that Liverpool penalty area with a yard or two. Lee, Neil, oh, charge in the back by Dry on rush. Quite properly the free kick given. Ian Rush in a tremendous burst of form with 20 goals this season. Dalglish. A little bit frantic at the moment while teams try to sort themselves out a little bit. Well, what a good touch by Dalglish from McDermott. Danger for Chelsea, and the chip just a little bit too high for Liverpool's point of view, but Dalglish's little touch was perfection and was a very early warning indeed as to what Chelsea might expect. He's got a bit of an eye wound that he picked up in the midweek game against Ipswich, but his vision was really unimpaired there. Playing it for Lee. Didn't mean to get it back to Pates, but it arrived there nonetheless. Hales. And a break now. Good bit of play and a good run by Locke. And Rhodes Brown meeting it first time. And Liverpool just for once were caught out on the far side as Walker got back onto an onside position. And the referee had judged that Locke's timed run was perfectly okay. And here's Locke on that run, and he slung in a good cross, and Rhodes Brown hit it high and wide. Following. Quick change of mind. Nothing. Fillery again. Locke's made a break down the right, and Fillery picked him out superbly. Cross perhaps. Souness in the way. And finding Hansen. Neil. McDermott. And Lee. And away goes Rhodes Brown. Now, has he got the nerve to hold on? horse's ability to keep their concentration and their stamina at the highest possible level for every second of this game. Lee now taking it for Rhodes Brown, played it towards Walker. Now Hales trying to dip it back again. The little clip cross once more as Lee comes in, and Lawrenson was grateful to put that away for the corner. What a good break again by Chelsea. Well deserving the corner. And Walker wasn't far from getting in on it. So a few anxious glances in that Liverpool defence. As Chelsea get another corner, coming towards the near post. Hales will get a chance to hit it back in once more towards Troy, but Sammy Lee getting it as far as Dalglish. Now Hanson, a break on for Liverpool. Lee has gone through the middle, Whelan is on this side, important there for Nutton to have got his header in, which he did. Now Rhodes Brown, leaving it for Hales. Hutchins back to the safety of his keeper. So there's in the picture. But here are Liverpool again. Still Hanson, but Liverpool still a goal down. McDermott on the turn, good save. Again the warning for Chelsea, that if you give them half a yard of extra space, you could be in trouble. And France is saving well from McDermott. Neal's coming up from the back, Whelan's in there, rushes at the near post. There aren't that many red shirts in the box at the moment though. They played it wide there for McDermott and he's got a bit of space. Oh, crossbar, that's twice they've hit the woodwork. And Liverpool are having no luck at all. With Rush having hit the post, McDermott then hitting the crossbar. Possibly touched on by the keeper. No, I don't think he did. No, it was a clean hit. Here comes Lawrence. Dalglish. Foul that time by Prince. Maybe it was a foul by Nutton. Before the ball came through towards McDermott. A free kick to Liverpool at any rate. Dermot over it. Rush very active up front there. Whelan trying to get in behind them on the far side. Does so across the face of that goal again. And yet again, Liverpool are doing everything right, but just cannot get the ball in the net. It was a good late run there by Ronnie Whelan. After Souness had taken that free kick, studied attention there. He got in well across the goal. A good long ball down that flank for Rush. It's a Liverpool throw. It's a free kick for the foul by Nicky Joy on Ian Rush. Joy missed it, Hutchins didn't. Inside that Chelsea half, except Grobbelaar. Hanson coming forward, just wide again. Well, Chelsea have conceded only 4 goals in their last 7 games, but they've been living on a knife edge for the last 20 minutes or so. Good tense cup tie this, and Chelsea so well aware of the fact that they mustn't rest on one goal but certainly need to look for another one. And with that attacking intention and Liverpool's too, it's an excellent cup tie. Because he thought Walker was offside. It was the only thing he could do, really. Now, can he wriggle free? Hales again, trying to cross it in for Fillery, showing good control, but Neal was there for Liverpool. free kick for Liverpool. Hale's assault on Donny Whelan just a little too vigorous for the referee's liking, and it'll be a free kick. But I think it really should go back another 10 yards or so, to be perfectly fair, but it's now been taken, and here are Liverpool. Well, they haven't had this first half, which is now 4 minutes from its conclusion. Neil trying to get McDermott away, inside for Dalglish, hit first time, and he was a little lucky that it came back to him. Goal kick. Support coming up from this big Stamford Bridge crowd for the team in blue. Whelan now on the break for Liverpool. A nice little drag back by Dalglish, and a shot that's too high, and a goal kick. Walker. Hales. Pates. It's a good ball there. Fillery again for Hutchins, and Lawrenson nicely placed to get it away. A Chelsea throw, and we're playing time added on for stoppages at the end of the first half. Half-time whistle, and the unexpected at the moment is happening. They said it couldn't possibly happen that Chelsea could make Liverpool fight from behind, but that's just what's happened thanks to that 7th-minute goal by Peter Roachbrough. Chelsea have battled well, but Liverpool nonetheless have looked such a menacing side, with Ian Rush and Terry McDermott both hitting the Chelsea woodwork. It's a marvellous cup tie so far. I fancy that might continue in the second half as well. With a half-time score here at a bubbling Stamford Bridge, Chelsea 1, Liverpool 0. So Chelsea get the second half underway, attacking the goal to right, leading by a goal to nil, and 45 minutes away from an astonishing cup tie result. Mind you, they've not been beaten here since October when Barnsley beat them. Oh, but that's an own goal? No, it's not. Disastrous mistake that might have been in the first 30 seconds of the second half. The youngster, 40 for him, played it just a little bit wide. Rush. It's a phenomenal toss, even so, that faced Chelsea. When you think over the last 11 games, Liverpool have been striking almost at the rate of 3 goals a game. Neil battling everybody in point of fact, but nonetheless finding Sammy Lee. Dalglish off in pursuit. And Liverpool get a throw. Dalglish with it, and McDermott quicker to spot the possibilities than anybody else. Well, Francis got a touch, and Droy in fact got the one that mattered by putting it behind for the corner. But it was McDermott's quick thinking that suddenly put Chelsea into trouble until Troy got the one away for the corner. Lee, a little chip in here for Kennedy, and another corner for Liverpool. Well, they only had one corner in the first half, but they've had three now in the second. In the opening 2 minutes. Lee taking it from Kennedy. Rush crossed in well there. Phil Neal was in there too. Whelan miscued badly. That was a chance. Oh, Ronnie Whelan's been in amongst the goals lately. He's got 7 this season, and that really was coming out to a clear chance for him. Makes no odds, and clearly a problem now looming for Chelsea. A wall that needs to be organized efficiently and made absolutely watertight. Francis has got to get a sight of it. Kennedy is behind the ball, so too is Souness. Plenty in the wall. It'll be Souness. McDermott is lurking. Whelan is close at hand. Bates insisting that the Chelsea wall goes back to required 10 yards. A real problem now for Chelsea as Souness hammers it straight into the wall, and in fact it looked to me as though Locke almost gathered the ball up rugby style and might even have handled it. But the crowd was around the referee and he couldn't see it, and Chelsea might well have escaped there, even though Locke might well be feeling it in the pit of the stomach right now. And indeed he's still bending almost double. Well, the free kick really caught him, and it did serve Chelsea a service, but that there's no doubt. Wallop straight into his midriff, and it looked as though there must be a handball there. Still no luck for the man in the cap, Bob Paisley. But Locke now with the free kick. It was Lee who got the header in. Fury is trying to get in there, but it was Phil Neal who got it away for Liverpool. Hale's turning it on. And Kennedy just preventing Walker getting in from behind him. Chelsea's throw again. Gary Locke. Towards Colin Lee, rising well. Bates will try a shot himself, he has. Called for a good save from Grubelaar, from Colin Bates. Blake Johnston warming up. Quarter of an hour of the second half gone. Liverpool with a half an hour left now to repair the damage. And you have to say, the way they're playing, you get that inevitable feeling but it still will come right for them. Now, having the better of this second half, here's Lee playing it for Rush. Looking for Dalglish. Will it come for Whelan? Hanson. Kennedy. Neal. Souness. Bane Whelan in. Now McDermott. Fantastic test of the nerve and character, the growing character of this Chelsea side. They can hold on to Liverpool. Lee gets in the cross. Rhodes Brown gets it away. Souness tries to collect the puck. Lee plays one wide for the advancing Chris Hutchins now. The fullback, he's got Walker up with him. And the shot is a feeble one. But the break. So a quarter of an hour left. Can Chelsea hang on to this goal so early in the game? Can Liverpool, who've looked at times anxious but most times menacing, get the equaliser that at least will give them a replay at Anfield? No foul there, said the referee. It's surely going to be a pretty tense 15 minutes for both sides and both sets of supporters too. Good play by Hansel. What a space for Kennedy. Pulled down by Hales. The referee wanting a sharp word there, I thought, with Hales, because it seemed that the Liverpool player had beaten him. The free kick given on the edge of the box, though. Souness will take it. Johnson's on the far side. There might be a bit of space here if the ball was over. No, it's given as a corner. Chelsea fans howling that the ball was over before Kennedy connected. But the linesman said otherwise. Liverpool get another corner, and here's Kennedy. Soonest the captain. Played a little wider this time towards Whelan. And straight at the keeper. I don't think Steve Francis knew a lot about that until it actually hit him. But he stood up big and strong. And he collected. Played there for Walker. Can Chelsea find something here? Oh, Kobylarczyk, triple goal! Pulling knee! Well, they threw that away! And now that's going to take an awful lot of retrieving. The fans are on the field. And Colin Lee, who's not scored since before Christmas, was right on the spot. Suddenly, out of nothing, Chelsea produced what is sure to be a killer goal. Walker crosses it in, Neil and Grobbelaar get themselves in a terrible state, and Colin Lee is there to finish it off. And the Liverpool fans haven't a lot to say for themselves at the moment. Mind you, they've had plenty to cheer all season. Turning it in, Droy once again getting it away at the expense of another corner. Sammy Lee will take this one, perhaps. He's gone across to the corner spot, and even now Mickey Droy won't believe it's all over. He's summoning one last big effort from his team. Lee now, finding Kennedy, in for Dalglish, but stopped well by Walker, and that's the clearance that Chelsea fans wanted. Get a bit of distance. Hansen. Have won it! Those goals by Rhodes Brown and by Colin Lee. manufactured in his second division side, and just look at that for the team. They've been starved of success here for so long. And their supporters, because of the doings of the vast minority of them, have had a bad name. But the good Chelsea supporters say this is really like the old